Okay, in this next video, what I like to do is spend a little more time on the production function, once again, and the PPF, and go over an idea, this idea of diminishing returns to labor and capital. Okay, so remember this, the production function is the relationship between output and inputs, where we have our output is some function of the inputs. And the inputs we generally use in these production functions are labor, capital, sometimes human capital, and certainly technology. And sometimes in these production functions, for purposes of the regression, includes everything else besides this. So it kind of lump everything in, like corruption and property rights and all these institutions and trade, stick everything there into that category A that includes the technology. So for example, a typical production function that economists generate works something like this. Y equals capital to the alpha power times technology times labor to the beta power. Very common production function. It seems to fit a lot of models. And alpha and beta are less than one. What this means is that there's some diminishing returns to capital and labor. So some variable x to a power that's less than one will give a graph that looks something kind of like that. If we write something like y equals x to the first power, then it's just a straight line like that. And if we write y equals x to some power that's greater than one, up here, then it'll look something like that. This straight line is known as constant returns. And a line over here is known as increasing returns. And this first one here is diminishing returns. So in these production functions, we generally write capital and labor to some power less than one, showing that there's some diminishing returns. And remember, diminishing returns is the same thing as increasing opportunity cost. So for example, if we write output over here on the independent axis, and we put labor over here, output on the dependent axis and labor on the independent axis, then as we increase labor, output will go up, but there'll be diminishing returns, holding everything else constant. So holding capital constant, and I'll put a little bar over K, showing it's not really a variable, it's like constant here, and technology constant, and human capital constant, holding everything else constant. If we just start increasing labor, output will go up, but there'll be diminishing returns to it. So if we have this amount of labor, we'll get this amount of output, but if we have, say, this amount of labor, we'll call this L2, would double the labor, output will go up. We'll call it Y2, but Y2 won't be double what Y1 was, showing there are some diminishing returns to labor, holding everything else constant. So it's like, you can understand here, it's like we got the same amount of capital and technology, but we keep adding more people. That means there's going to be capital dilution. There's not going to be as many warehouses or machines per worker. They're not going to be as productive. So yeah, more people will add more output, but they're not as productive. So you double the people, and there's not going to be double the output. So this shows some diminishing returns then to labor. Or think of it as there's a pizza parlor and they've got 10 people there and they can produce 1,000 pizzas. And you double the number of people in the pizza parlor, there's 20 workers. Well, it's a small place. There's only so many machines and ovens that make the pizza. They'll be able to produce more pizzas, but probably not double the amount of pizzas that they were making before. If you keep adding more and more people, pretty soon they become they can't even produce more because they're all tripping over each other. Now we can do the same thing with capital. We can put output Y over here, put capital on the independent axis, the X axis. We hold everything else constant, the number of people, labor's constant. We'll hold labor constant, human capital constant, technology constant. And guess what? We'll see diminishing returns to capital also. So if we were to double the amount of capital, holding everything else constant, we don't double the output of the economy. There's diminishing returns to capital. Now, if we were to increase the amount of labor, say this is L1, that's the amount of labor. If we were to increase the amount of labor, we could produce more. And what that would do, that would move this curve up with more labor, where L2 is greater than L1. More labor, we should be able to produce more, but there's still going to be this diminishing returns to capital. We can do the same thing with human capital. There's diminishing returns to human capital. We start educating people over and more and more and more. They'll get a higher salary, but there's diminishing returns to it. Now in this next graph here, I'm going to take output and capital, like in this graph, but I'm going to divide both by L. And have a graph here where I have Y over L on the dependent axis and capital over L on the independent axis. Now, capital over L, remember, is the amount of capital per worker. So this would be the capital labor ratio, capital to labor ratio. And the higher it is, that means to move up, we would have capital deepening. If we had less, it would call capital dilution. And Y over L, which is output per worker, is productivity. That is the amount that can be produced by labor. And there's diminishing returns to it. So if we keep adding capital and keep the number of people fixed, you can see that they'll become more productive, but there's still diminishing returns to it. So what this graph shows is We can increase our productivity by adding capital, but there's diminishing returns to it. So we can keep adding more and more capital, enough that even though labor is increasing, we increase capital more than the amount of labor. So our capital labor ratio is increasing. It increases productivity, but we don't get quite the bang for the buck for it. There's diminishing returns to it, even with the capital deepening. There may be some optimal point, some sort of optimal, K over L, optimal point for society, because we don't want to just increase capital, the labor ratio, forever because of the diminishing returns. Now, if we were to increase technology, then that would shift this whole curve upward. There's still diminishing returns of the capital labor ratio, but we could keep shifting that curve upward as technology increases. So, speaking of technology, if we were to put technology down here on the A-axis, independent axis, and output over here on the Y-axis, and hold everything else constant, K, L, and human capital, would there be diminishing returns? What do you think it would look like? Constant returns? Increasing returns or decreasing returns? The data seems to show constant returns to technology. And that's why generally in the production function that we went through up here, when technology is put into the production function, empirically, it turns out that the exponent on this A term, which is the technology, is 1, meaning there's constant returns to technology. Now, the current thinking by economists, it keeps changing on growth. A while ago, the thinking was, well, we grow at the rate of technology increases. Developing countries grow at whatever. The main thing is technology. Whatever the increase in technology is what causes countries to grow. Now the thinking is, maybe we can control our own growth rates, because technology is determined a lot by the amount of effort we spend on research and development. So if research and development determines technology and technology determines growth, well, then we might be able to determine our own growth rate by devoting more resources to research and development. So on the production function, if we were to say, put R&D over here and everything else that's produced out of output, the consumer goods and producer goods and all that kind of stuff, well, then we could draw a PPF like this. And if our choices by society are up here, a high rate of research and development, as opposed to a lower rate of research and development, then we could push the PPF out there further and grow faster. So that's the current thinking right now. We may be able to control our own rate of growth. It's a choice that we want to make by society in how much we want to devote to research and development. Okay, so that concludes this video on the production function in the growth models and the diminishing returns to labor and capital. So economists think there's diminishing returns to practically everything. There's diminishing returns to capital. There's diminishing returns to labor. There's diminishing returns to human capital. The only way that you can avoid this problem is increase all of them at the same time. So if you have a pizza parlor and you're making pizzas, if you just increase the number of people, there's diminishing returns. You just increase the number of pizza ovens or the size of the building, there's diminishing returns to it. What you have to do is increase all of them at the same time. So you not only increase the number of people that are working, but you increase the size of the pizza parlor also, and their training also. So essentially you take a big restaurant, duplicate the entire restaurant somewhere else, and then you don't get the diminishing returns to it. Because the diminishing returns are increasing one thing, but holding everything else constant.